Students, now we will move on to the last kingdom, that is animal kingdom or kingdom Animalia. As the name suggests, animal kingdom includes all the type of animals, all type of animals, starting from sponges to the highest group, highest or well-developed group called as mammals. All those animals, they come under this kingdom, animal kingdom. But before we study those groups one by one, we should have knowledge of some typical terminologies. First, I'll make you clear with all those terminologies, because again and again we use that terminology, then you should not get confused. Let us take the terminologies one by one. First of all, the terminology is levels of organization. Levels of organization. Levels of organization. What is this level of organization? We know what are cells. Cells are the basic unit of life, structural and functional unit of living organism, or life is called as cell. And what is tissue? Group of cell is called as tissue. Cells group together to perform a common function, and then we call them as tissues. We know that. Okay. So first is cell. Cell group together to form tissue. Tissues group together to perform a common function called as organ. Organ. Now, for example, stomach is an organ. It is made up of many types of tissues. Heart is organ, group of tissues. And organ further, several organ combined together to form organ system. Organ system. One example, digestive system. Digestive system is association of several organ, starting from mouth, tongue, esophagus, stomach, pancreas, liver, small intestine, large intestine. So many organs combined together to form digestive system. It is organ system. You take circulatory system. Circulatory system is combination of several organ, blood vessels, that is arteries, veins, heart, and so on. So that is circulatory system. So like this, our body organ systems are composed of organ. Organ is composed of tissue, and tissue is composed of cell. This we know. Now we will understand what is levels of organization. First of all, cellular level of organization. Cellular level of organization. What is this cellular level of organization? You take our example. In our body, there are n number of cells. Crores of cells are there in our body. And so we are multicellular. And all the cells, they combine together. Here and there, they combine together to form tissue to perform a common function. They combine together to form tissue and perform the function. Whereas cellular level means, though they are multicellular, though an animal or an organism is multicellular, cells never combine to form tissue. Many cells will be there, but they never combine to form tissue. Each cell work independently. Each cell work independently. I'll give one simple example. If you take classroom, imagine in classroom there are 40 students, and each student is a cell. For example, each student is a cell. Now, all the students at a time study biology. Then it is organized. Cells combine together, say for to form tissue. Now, each student study their own subject. One student is studying physics, another student biology, another student chemistry, one more mathematics, one more social, one more is playing music, one more is playing with some game. So this type of mechanism is called as cellular level. Though there are many cells, they do not combine together to form tissue and do the function. They individually work. This is called as cellular level of organization. And this is seen in case of sponges. Later on I'll tell you what are sponges. There is a group of organism called as sponges. Now, next one. Tissue level organization. Tissue level. Here slightly advanced than this. Here cells are combined to form tissues. Cells are combined to form tissues. But tissues are not combined to form organ to perform the function. So all the functions are carried out at tissue level, no organ. Here at cell level, no tissue. Here at tissue level, no organ. And example for this is, you can give example of Hydra. Hydra is example for tissue level of organization. And then comes organ level or organ system level. Organ level. In many of the higher organism, okay, maybe our body, you take cockroach is also organ level. They have many organs, tissues combined together to form organ. So that is higher level, organ level. And automatically when there are many organ, organ coordinate together to form organ system level of organization. So this is the concept of levels of organization. So one concept is clear. Now I will take you to another concept, the concept of symmetry. The concept of symmetry. Symmetry. Let us see what is this symmetry. There are three types of symmetry. Radial symmetry. Bilateral symmetry and asymmetry. Asymmetry. What is this? Radial symmetry, bilateral symmetry and asymmetry. You take any organism. You take any organism. Okay. For example, say jellyfish. Jellyfish. Jellyfish will be somewhat like this. Jellyfish. This is jellyfish. Which looks like umbrella. This is jellyfish. Okay. Or starfish. I'll take a jellyfish. Now, we can divide this jellyfish into two equal half in any plane. You cut in any plane, you will get two equal half. As in case of any circular thing. Suppose a cake. This is cake. During birthday time, we cut the cake. This is the center of the cake. I want to cut the cake into two equal half. If I cut like this, I'll get two equal half. Or if I cut like this, then also I'll get two equal half. Or if I cut like this, then also I'll get two equal half. Like this, if we divide an organism into two equal half in any plane passing through the center, then it is called as radial symmetry, as in case of jellyfish or in case of starfish. Bilateral symmetry. Bilateral symmetry means we can divide the organism into two equal half in any one plane. In any one plane. If it is a triangular structure, I want to cut the triangle into two equal pieces. If I cut like this, I'll not get equal piece. I have to cut like this. Then only I'll get two equal part. So human being itself or fish. You take example of fish. Okay. If you take example of fish, just for reference, if I cut the fish like this, I'll get two equal half. Whereas if I cut the fish like this, then I will not get two equal half. That is bilateral symmetry. We can divide the organism into two equal half in one particular plane. And asymmetry, you try to divide in any plane, you will not get two equal half. As in case of amoeba. Amoeba is of different type of shape. You cannot cut them into two equal half in any plane, and then you call them as asymmetry. So this is the concept of symmetry, radial, bilateral and asymmetric.